children. In the last video, I have explained you about noun. Now, I am going to explain you the types of nouns. Here, what is a noun? A noun is a word that functions as the name of something. Here, there are 8 types of nouns. One is common noun, proper noun, countable noun, uncountable noun, concrete noun, abstract noun, compound noun, and collective noun. First, we'll go through common noun. Here, the common noun is used to name people, places, or things in general. It refers to the class, a type of person, a thing, without being specific. Generally, the girl comes under common noun because here we are not specifying any particular name. An animal. All the animals we call animal in general. But here again we are not specifying any particular name. In the same way, a fruit. In general we are calling a fruit. Here the common nouns means a girl, animal, fruit, house, means in general we speak not a particular name. Now we are going to the next proper noun. Used to name a specific or individual person, place, or thing. For example, John, London. Pluto, France. Here, the specific name of a person, John. We are calling him with a specific name. London, the specific name of a city. We gave a name to the city. France, the specific name of a country. So, if you give a particular or specific name to a noun, that is called proper noun. Now, next, countable nouns have a singular and a plural form and can be used with the number an before it. They are sometimes called count nouns. Example, car, desk, cup, house, bike. Here, car, cars, cup, cups, bike, bikes. It's in a singular form or a plural form. If you can count the number of things or persons or anything, that comes under countable nouns. Now we are going to the next one, uncountable nouns. Uncountable nouns means cannot be counted. We cannot count. That is called uncountable nouns. Here, for example, wood, air, milk, happiness, a substance or a material, or a liquid, an abstract idea. Can you count a liquid like that? In the same way, an abstract idea or a substance, that comes under uncountable nouns. Here, for example, rain. We can't count the raindrops, and we can't count cheese, and we can't count blood drops also. So, which are uncountable words are called uncountable nouns. Now, we are going for the next one, concrete noun. Refer to the people or things that exist physically and that at least one of them senses can detect. Means dog. We can see this. Yes, physically we can see the dog. Tree, apple. We can taste this. Apple we can see and we can taste it also. Moon, sock. We can smell this. So any particular sense will act in this. So concrete nouns means we can physically, at least we can see, taste or smell. This comes under concrete nouns. We'll go for the next one. Abstract noun. Have no physical existence. They refer to ideas, emotions and concepts. We cannot see, touch, hear, smell or taste. Abstract noun means here the feelings, emotions and concepts comes under abstract noun. Means here love. We cannot express. We can express but we cannot show. Fear, luck, these are all comes under abstract noun. It physically there is no existence for the abstract nouns, but we can show a feeling, an emotion and a concept. It's called an abstract noun. Now the next one, compound noun. Two or more words that create a noun. They can be written as one word joined by a hyphen or written as a separate words. Now here, compound noun means joining two words together is a compound word. The same, if it is a noun, then it is a compound noun. For example, here, rainfall. There are two words in rainfall. One is rain and one is fall. We are joining two words here. rainfall that comes under compound noun. Son-in-law, somewhere we are joining the son-in-law by hyphens, putting hyphens. Son-in-law. Here it also comes under compound noun because there is a compound word. Credit card is also separate words. Credit card. It comes under compound noun. Toothbrush, jack in the box and bus stop are compound nouns. Now we are going for the next one. Collective nouns refer to a set of group of people, animals or things. Example, team, pile, flock, stack, bunch. Here, for example, a group of people is comes under collective noun, means a team of players, a pile of books, flock of sheep, birds, bunch of grapes, bunch of flowers. Now, collective noun means collectively persons, collectively the people, collectively anything comes under collective noun. Now, going for the next one. Here, team, a group of players or members, a group of birds, a group of bananas or flowers, etc. comes under collective noun. Now, types of noun, common noun, proper noun, countable, uncountable, concrete, abstract, compound and collective are called types of nouns. Here, I think, I hope everybody understood the topic of types of nouns. Thank you.